to be honest, my biggest fear is that we're losing wild species all over the world. And through my entire career, I decided that the one way that we might be able to prevent that is to do the basic science to say, what is it that these animals need to live in this crazy changing world? That connection between facilities like the Georgia Aquarium and the work that we do in the wild, being able to make that transition is, you know, priceless, absolutely priceless, if we want to have animals like this in the world. So imagine you have wild beluga whales. What if a ship comes by? What if seismic exploration is going on and the animals are going to swim really, really fast to get away? They feel that they're in danger. Those are calories expended that they could have used for growth, for maintaining their health, and for even reproducing. How many beluga whales can you have in a population and not compete with them for those calories coming from fish by our own fishing activities as a human population that wants to eat the same kind of fish? So that's the study here. There are three phases to the study at the Georgia Aquarium. We're working right now at just getting resting metabolic rate, resting calories. Phase two is where we start adding in the other parts. Beluga whales swim. So now we want to know, how many calories does it take them to swim fast? How much does it take them to swim slow? And the third piece is the cost of diving, because that's how beluga whales find food in the wild. Now we want to relate this to wild beluga whales. It isn't just a matter of understanding that basic swimming biology. We also want to know, what does it cost a wild beluga whale to swim?
This study came about because of the Cook Inlet beluga whale population, which has been decreasing despite some different controls that have been put in place to try and protect them. And so we're working with the National Marine Fisheries Service in order to try and understand more and build a model that will help us predict what some of these different impacts are having on them and how we can protect them better. And so working here with Georgia Aquarium, it, like I said, it gives it that really controlled environment, that incredible team to work with, so we can get really accurate data for putting into that model and for helping to protect those animals in that population specifically, and the larger population as well.
With the whales that we have here, we want them to be ambassadors for their species. And so when we get the opportunity to participate in a research study like this one, it really means a lot. These animals and us as a training team, like, we are helping beluga whales globally. And it's a really empowering feeling. It's a really rewarding feeling. And I'm so proud of the animals and the team that I get to work with every day.